Welcome people from everywhere, gamers out there watching this stream. This is Htaed7-RCT bringing you another live stream for you guys tonight. Actually today, the whole day has been very special, very nice. I'm happy to report that I've been pretty happy. Happy because, as many people like to say, sometimes the magic comes in small packages or something along those lines. And yes, that's basically what's been going on my side of things. I mean, tonight I'm going to cover or showcase, basically I'm bringing back, after a long hiatus, the Shoot 'em Up Crossfire series, which is basically a stream of shoot 'em ups, which is a genre that I absolutely love, right up there with role-playing games and fighters. So yeah, I'm stoked. But not only am I doing this tonight, doing the shoot 'em ups, but I'm also featuring it, giving it a special flavor. Yes, it will be a Sega Saturn shoot 'em up Crossfire, meaning that some of the best titles, shooters available on the console, I'm going to be showcasing them for you guys here tonight. But that is not the only thing that makes me happy. See, there's several other things that I would like to point out before going into the gameplay screen, as I usually do. Now, first off, is that today is the second anniversary, or like I like to call it, the second happy birthday of AtariAge.com Neo Geo forums, commandeered by my good friend Anthony, also known in some circles as Charlie Cat. The guy's amazing. I mean, I can't say enough good things about the guy, and I'm so happy that they are celebrating right now. So if you're the kind of gamer that really likes to get your info on different consoles and systems and stuff like that, and you want to embrace a community that appreciates what you bring to the table, be it small or big or whatever, or just want to relax and have a good time with your peers, considering how negative the freaking internet is at times when it comes to gaming, I would recommend you highly to go to AtariAge.com, search for the Neo Geo forums there, and you're going to be pleasantly surprised. Of course, this is triple bonus if you're a fan of Neo Geo console, because you're going to have so much info there that you're going to go crazy. So kudos and a big shout out to those guys over there celebrating. I hope that this is from here on out, the forums grow beyond your imagination, because I know how much care and love you put into that project. So I'm all for that. I respect that, and best luck to you. Second up, which I wanted to mention, but I'm gonna bring it up here really quick. As you can see, I'm bringing there to the screen, I received a copy, this first copy of the Hyper Play RPG. It's a fanzine that I got from the great people all the way over from UK. This came in the mail, and I was so stoked about checking this out. I mean, it came out of nowhere. The guys behind the magazine, they even approached me, you know, and I'm an average Joe. I'm just a regular gamer, and they approached me very nicely, and they said, hey, if you're interested in this, let us know. And they were, sure enough, they were kind enough to send me this fanzine, which I gotta say, I mean, it's absolutely amazing. Here's where the magic and small things come into full effect. In a day and age on the internet, and I cannot stress this enough, where everywhere you go as a gamer, you're confronted with so much negativity and trolls and people with their console wars, and it's, you know, every day it's all about graphics and this machine is better than this one, and if you don't like this or you're not on my band, you suck, you this and that. You get tired of crap like that. There's many factors in why it has become like this, but I'm not going to go into detail. That'll be for another discussion, of course. But this right here is a fresh of is a it's just amazing. It's just something that I see it as going back, harkening back to a time where, you know, there were simpler things, but those simpler things were put in so much passion and love into them, those things, that you couldn't help but just love it. And this is just an example of love and care. I mean, okay, to many people out there, the first impression is going to be like, you know, it's okay, it's cool, it's, what's the big deal? It's a magazine, it's a fanzine, a small one at that, it's in black and white, but yeah, that's where we go again into the whole territory of nitpicking and being negative about stuff. This fanzine right here harkens back to a time where internet was not of influence, where a lot of passion, a lot of hard work would go into bringing information about certain games, about the hobby that we all love so much. And the thing is that, like I mentioned before, I still stand by that comment. It feels to me, this work is, it feels to me like the beginnings of a magazine that I still hold dear and I miss very much, which is Game Fan. Now, of course, Hyperplay RPG is a for now, it's a magazine that's aiming to go like worldwide. And my opinion, of course, is a bit tainted, if you will, by the fact that I'm accustomed to a more Western approach, a more American approach. But even so, even if I cannot relate to certain things because I am not there physically, like some of the more local references of places and stuff, it's still fascinating. I mean, it's like a chunk of gaming that's coming from another part of the world, and you feel how you can connect with these people through this simple little mag. Now, I see the potential. Now, I don't want to be rambling for too long, but I see the potential of this growing even probably beyond the editor's expectations. I mean, I haven't gone through the whole thing, but just seeing how they review not only some of the greatest RPG games that has been, you know, around for quite some time, they review new games, which is completely amazing to me. They're more Nintendo centric, and that is a huge plus for me, because I'm not a Nintendo fanboy, but I am, and I do appreciate their contribution. So the fact that they don't come at me as a reader with this negative spin, but they just approach and embrace what's good about gaming, has me on board. You know, I will find a way to become a subscriber because I want to see where this goes. I want to see where this goes. And I wish them the best of luck. You guys are doing an amazing job. I'm going to actually post here. Go to this link right here, right up here, and you'll find everything you need to know about the zine, about what's their pitch, you know, what are they trying to bring. And you're going to be pleasantly surprised. You know, count on that, please. Go ahead. If you need to pause the video when you see this on YouTube, go right ahead. I mean, if I could make it easier for you guys, but just go there and check it out, and you will be pleasantly surprised. So, that being said, I know I took a lot of time there, but it had to be said. I mean, the Neo Geo Forum's birthday, and this had me very happy, very chipper, if you may, today. So yeah, that is a good thing. So let's go into this. Let's bring down, oh, I just cut it off, Jesus. All right, let's bring down the music and let's get the Saturn set up and running, baby. Gotta do this. We go, that's our Saturn. Now let's hold on, let's get, I'm going to start things off going a bit cheery to reflect that happy mood that I'm feeling right now. So basically, the first one I'm going to start with is actually a title known as Cotton 2. I don't need to go into too much detail about how awesome this game is. You're going to see for yourself. And I'm going to have some fun playing this game. There's in this game there is some of the best 2D art on the system. It's just a fun little shooter, very anime influence, as you can see by the style, but it has a few pretty cool mechanics to it, absolutely love. The fact that you can grab enemies and use those enemies, you know, throw them back, the leveling up system, the fact that you have actually three, not just one character, but you can basically switch from character with different styles, and the music, animation, and everything about this game is just, it exudes quality. It's a very, very fun game. Plus you have the grabbing and throwing mechanic, as you can see here in just a second. See, you catch, and use the same button that you use to catch and throw right back, making it for a nice little attack. And I believe you can chain those attacks by constantly throwing the enemies back at each other. I mean, for someone like me who absolutely loves 2D art, this is like, well, it's common knowledge. I mean, Saturn was hailed and still is hailed as a shooter, not only a shooter heaven, but a 2D heaven. Also like to take the opportunity to thank the guys over at Inner Ghost Retro Records. I mean, this week I've had tons of fun with the whole 1942 record setting and all that stuff. It's been a long, long time that I haven't wanted to do something along those lines. Oh my god, I keep getting knocked. That wasn't fun. Well, that was fun, I just sucked. Okay, let's choose this one, and this one. Alright, let's do this. Gotta stay away from that thing. Get away, get away, get away! You only have a certain amount of times you're able to switch between characters, so you can't just go ahead and be switching all the time. It's part of the strategy, I guess, in the game. Bonus stage! Yeah! Grab those points, baby. Alright. stage. Now I know that this one actually, I think, this one came first and is in the same vein of Death Smiles, another of one of my favorite shoot 'em ups. At least the side scrolling kind, one of my favorite shoot 'em ups. Grab one of those fruits. Power of heavy metal to guide me here while playing the shooter, but then you wouldn't be able to listen to the great music that went into this game too. But look at all this, look at all the action in here. Alright, one more try before we skip to the next game. Apparently, I don't have my A game time. Keep it up. Holy crap! Holy crap! Got me. Time. Come on, grab those teas. Whoa. now. I love these multi-jointed enemies. Always love that. Always reminds me of treasure games. Alright, got ourselves a barrier. That's what I'm talking about. Uh-oh. Yep. That's it. That's it for Cotton 2. Let's see what else we can muster up here. Oh, I guess this one is one that's going to be very familiar to you guys. And I know I play it a lot. At least the arcade version, I play constantly. But it's one of those games that are, oh my god, they're legendary. I know they've had HD versions of them. Of course, it's Cave. It has to be legendary. And, yep. Dodonpachi. Now, let's see what we got here in the options. Difficulty normal. Bonus. Three chances. Let's go to five. Just to play it safe. See normal. You have normal display mode. What's this tape thing? Let's try that out and see. Press R to return to Saturn. I think we're set and ready. Now, besides the display, oh, okay, sideways. Okay. That's what they meant by that. Yeah, gotta change that. All right. I'm gonna try out the Saturn mode. I never played the Saturn mode, and see how different it might be. Hey, buddy, what's up? Came in just in time to see or watch with me the Saturn version of Dodonpachi. I'm gonna try the Saturn mode, see how different that is from what we're used to playing in the arcade. I'm guessing you gotta be tired as hell. Let's choose shot or laser. I'm gonna go with shot. Damn good. Little bit of slowdown there because, of course, being emulated and being emulated with this nice resolution, that's going to be a bit taxing. But it's still pretty responsive even with a whole lot of stuff going on screen, holding up pretty well. Ah, thanks, buddy. Thanks about the record. I know it's something that's not gonna last. I mean, I never put too much weight into records because that's setting yourself up for disappointment. I mean, it was something that I did. It was fun. If it's broken, it's broken. And then it'll give me at least some incentive to work harder. That's the way records work. But you had me a bit scared there for a second, because I don't know, the way you reacted to the high score made me remember, you remember the whole debacle with the Donkey Kong high score? I forgot the name of the guys involved, but oh my god, that was like, that was crazy war between those two. I don't enjoy it that much. Alright, let's drop the A-bomb here. Billy Mitchell. That's it. That's the guy I was talking about. That guy, Billy Mitchell and the other one, man, they really went at it. I mean, they were like really invested in that shit. It's like, okay. To me, I wouldn't go that far because I know myself and I know my limitations and shit. And it's best, you know, to have fun with what you're doing. If you're gonna be so upset like those guys got, there's no, that's like no point in doing it. But the guys over at Inner Ghost, the guy Adam, he's really a cool guy, man. He checked out the video and put up the score, and that was more than I expected. So I'm pretty happy with the outcome. Yeah, I think that's the name.
You're approaching the target of attack. Your mission starts now. Are you ready?
But they were like really at it, you know, to the point where they were like, calling the other a cheater, and no, and you did it this way and that way, and it was like really ugly. To be honest, they look really stupid doing that. But that's the problems when egos start, you know, flaring up and shit. You shouldn't put so much weight into something that's, and at the end of the day, just something that's supposed to be fun. I mean, if you're dedicated, like, let's say a professional gamer and that's like your job, even then you shouldn't be, you know, you shouldn't get that way. You should only just practice and improve, and that's it. If you do it, it's okay. If not, you did your best. That's the most you can expect out of it. Now this is really kind of slowing down. Hey, got Afro Soul just coming in. Ah, hey. Now, I want to tell you, just like I'll tell anybody else who comes in later on, check out the first part of this video on YouTube so you can check out the little preview I did on Hyperplay. Really, really cool fanzine that's being done by a lot of cool people that love gaming just like us. Yeah, but it's, again, man, it's, I know it's all part of the fun is the whole trash talking and I'm gonna get you this and that, but I come from having a lot of experience with people who this kind of shit like goes to their head and they completely turn into different people, and I don't like that. We've had our conversations, Aaron. You know that I've had like this guy that I talked to you about, who you know was a cool guy. He's a nice guy, but he turned into a complete dick, a complete asshole, because he let his ego like take the better part of him, and I don't want to be that guy, dude. I don't want to be that guy. I don't want to be the douchey guy. You know. Yeah. But among other things, buddy, it's I don't know if you already checked it out or if you left the post over or whatever, but today's the second anniversary of the Neo Geo forums, dude. If you haven't stopped by, man, go ahead and give them a shout, because I'm very happy for Anthony, man. He deserves all the praise that he can get, because I know he's been working hard at that, and you know it too. I made him a small avatar in the logo to commemorate the second anniversary, and he's pretty stoked. Hopefully he'll be able to drop by and say hi. If not, I get it, because I've been noticing that he's been fending off and taking like a lot of questions and stuff with new members coming in, and I know that's hard work, man. Trying to keep on top of that is not easy. So far I've been talking here and not dying. I think I died once. I gotta say, the music is pretty rocking on this version of Goranpachi. Of course, that has to be the benefit, of course, of the CD format. Here, suck on some bombs, baby. I didn't want to die. Oh my God. Thank you, Afro Soul, for bringing in the chow. This tastes really good. Alrighty. I'm really hungry. Set it aside for a little later. Probably, as soon as I finish this small run here with Goranpachi, I'll go in with Panzer Dragoon Sway. Because that's like one of the staples of the Saturn. And an amazing shooter as well. Mm-hmm. Man, I know it's slowing up a little bit, but besides that, the hiccups, considering the kind of like resed up resolution that it's running, and that amazing music, man, I can't get over that soundtrack. The soundtrack is amazing. But on the flip side, I mean, you can't expect less from Cave. I mean, with this soundtrack, I don't even miss having my heavy metal on. And you got the metal straight from the game. Has like a Steve Vai vibe to it for some reason. Power up, baby. Now, Aaron, all joking aside with the whole, record thing, one thing that I liked about Intergo's Retro Records is the fact that there's a lot of consoles and games that are up for grabs, you know, to establish like a record. I know I'm gonna go back because there's several SNES games that I would like to do some, and of course arcade games. I mean, these shooters right here, I mean, I know I would have a ton of fun, you know, setting some records and some games that are not, you know, posted up yet. Cool beans, bro. I wanna see the video though. As soon as I finish here, I'll go over to YouTube to check out the vid. Ah!
Power up.
That's cool because it means that as soon as the score is reflected, you're gonna be up to second place again. Because I think they already validated one of the other, or two of the other guys that weren't verified yet, from what I saw. I'm gonna sit through it and give it another try, but I'm gonna, no pun intended, but I'm gonna shoot for something much higher than that, but I need to set it up correctly. If not, it's not gonna work. All right, I'm gonna leave it right there and go to the next cool Saturn game here. Now for Panzer Dragoon, I have to do something different. I have to first mount the image, so you guys give me a second here while I get this going, because for some reason Panzer Dragoon, it doesn't run like right off the game like the other ones. This one needs to be mounted with a Daemon tools. So yeah, let's go here and look for Panzer Dragoon Sway. I hope I'm pronouncing that right, not making an ass of myself. So that should be it. Let's take this out and let's go and run it. There we go. That's right. And speaking of heat, these fries are gonna get cold. There we have it. The beautiful, the classic, the legendary Panzer Dragoon Sway. I'm hoping I'm saying that correctly. Now, what do we have in terms of options? Up, down, normal, reverse. Well, yeah, I think I'm going to keep it normal because it's not first person, it's third person. Controller settings, you get pretty simple. I think I can live with that. All right. So, TV mode, should it be wide? Should it be... I'm gonna keep it normal for now. If it looks a little off, then I'll change it. All right, let's do this. I'm gonna try and skip the cinematics because I don't wanna lose too much time on the cinematics. Besides, most of the cinematics you can, you know, check it out at any time in YouTube in very short videos. Or, of course, by playing the damn game. But basically the whole premise is that these race of dragons that they have among this village or among these people, they are starting to eliminate those that they find with a greenish light inside. They are ordered to kill them because they can be a menace. They bring, they're kind of like a bad omen to their village and their people, so they're basically killing them. As soon as they find them, they kill them. And the boy, the protagonist here, he has his own dragon that has that light, and he's hiding it away so it won't get killed. Basically, that's how it starts. So I'm gonna go into the game itself. This game in itself, the gameplay mechanics is amazing. It's for its time very, very revolutionary. And this is coming from a hardcore treasure game fan. And when it comes to Sin and Punishment for treasure, that game is like, that's like the best, man. And this game, or this series of games, did that same concept years before, you know, the treasure got their hands on doing that. So you got 360 degree movement. But part of the gameplay is a little bit like on rails and stuff. It doesn't make it any less fun though. Exactly. Now sadly, the first time that I got to play one of these, unfortunately wasn't on the original Saturn, like this game, but basically I got to play the, what was it, I think it was for the Xbox, the first one. And I was floored. I really, like for the first time, I really envied not being able to have the Saturn because of this game. And even for the Saturn that wasn't a quote-unquote 3D machine, like many people like to say, you know, they call the Saturn a 2D monster, but in terms of 3D, it was behind the PlayStation and so on and so forth. It actually pulled off, in this game, it pulled off 3D pretty damn good. Beautiful. Episode 2. Let's go right ahead. Watching at all angles because you don't know where they're gonna come from. Damn, die, dude! What the hell? Oh, I'm catching. Oh, how about these little huts? Hey, Anthony! Happy birthday, buddy! Happy birthday to you and the gang! And again, Anthony, your timing is precious, as always. You got here exactly when I was playing Panzer Dragoon, the game that you were asking about. Them freaking Jedi tricks, man. You got that down to a science, bro. Here is this beauty of a game. And it's true, it's not running in its natural form, but it still looks beautiful. And now I'm in the air. Oh my god. transition from being on the ground to the air is absolutely amazing. Wow. Berserk attacks. Oh, I don't got no more berserk attack. I gotta charge it. I don't know how, but there you go. Yeah, we got some targeting going on now. Woo! That's what I'm talking about. I think this game, I'm going to go back to it and have me a long, long marathon. I already have the berserk attack already charged up, ready to lay waste to everything. Holy crap, I love it. Guys, aside from the obvious choice that is this game right here, what shooters are your favorite from the platform? Holy crap, I have two big ones right here in front. Ah, can't see with smoke. Are they behind? Are they in front? Where are they? There you go. Yep, destroyed. Good. Here comes the boss. Let's do this. That destruction. Hurry up, meter, and charge up. I can give it some nice little punishment. Nope! Get out of focus. Time to give him hell. Let's give him hell. Oh! Damn, I wasted that power. Started moving on me. You're almost dead, buddy. You're almost dead. There you go. Done and done. Incredibly beautiful. Now let's do one more stage so I can go right into the next game. Area 51. Now the first one, that's why I didn't run it. The first one is giving me a little bit of issue. For some reason it does not want to go. This one I found out that by running it using a virtual disk software like Daemon Pro Tools or Daemon Light Tools, you could actually get it running fairly good, as you can see. But the first one, for some reason, does not want to play nice. And since it's not up to quality standards, I didn't want to. But it's not because of the game, though. Nope, this side. Whoa. Holy crap, I just crashed into something. Oh. to berserk your asses. Stated enough. I mean, one of the things that draws me so much to the series is the fact that it's very similar in gameplay to Treasure's Sin and Punishment on the N64. If you guys haven't tried out that game, find a way, please. That game is absolutely a blast to play. Pun intended. Now, the sequel to that, Sin and Punishment 2, that came out for the Wii, that's another masterpiece from Treasure, and this game shares the same feel of the gameplay, you know, the shooting, the crazy abilities that you have, the way that you move around your target to fire on them and stuff. It's just like Treasure's game. That one, the one that I'm talking about, Sin and Punishment, was a game that never came to the statesides. It actually never released outside of Japan. And ironically, the whole game, the full game, even though it was a Japanese release, it was full with voiceovers and everything in English. You know, everything from the menus and everything about the game was English. You know, that's why they Nintendo brought it to the Wii, to the virtual console, and they didn't have to do any changes to the game because it was already localized. Oh my god, this is... It's funny how this game changed a lot of the games from this year or past year. And just in mechanics and the way everything animates. Feta is really pissed off. Here comes a shot. He's taking a shot. He's dead. Thank you. pretty cool, must say. So guys, I'm gonna stop it here, and though I'm having a good run, but I'm gonna stop it here because I don't wanna leave it here. I wanna get something. Okay, let me get Damon tools to unmount this for a second. Alright, so now next game. Oh, haha. I cannot finish this stream without doing this game. I mean, it would be absolutely idiotic. It's a classic, alright. But let's see what you guys think about this one. Yes! All hail the treasure! Woohoo! Oh yeah! Oh yeah! Radiant Silver Gun, baby! Oh, Saturn Arcade. Let's play the Saturn. Let's get some stock. Let's see if I have the need to use them. Okay, key configure. I think I'm gonna keep it as is, because so far every game has worked with the layout on my 360 pad, so I think should be good enough. I just hope it doesn't slow down too much. Oh yeah, baby. And I can imagine, Anthony, you coming across a whole bunch of people buying this game at outrageous prices, because it was for a very long time. If it isn't still now, absolutely crazy expensive. Okay, now I gotta see my different options here. Oh my god, I just went straight into the middle of that shot. The variety in this game is just crazy. That. Woohoo! Treasure and Cave, they rank very highly in my short list, right up there with Nintendo. Oh! They are part of a dying breed, my friends, of people who craft incredible experiences. This game is as beautiful as it is fun to play, and hard as hell, but it deserves all the accolades that it could get, man. Where's the... Oh, there it is. Still couldn't help me. down. It is a play of strategy and knowing what to do at what point, memorizing patterns. I don't care. The game is just cross right there in the middle. I'm gonna go for one more. Now, I am very much out of practice. That much I can accept. But the game, guys, the game plays flawlessly. And the fact that you have a weapon for each button just makes the shooter experience even more sweeter. Because you got choice. You got choice. Every freaking button is a weapon. It's just up to you how you use it. Now this title right here is the second title that actually made me feel sad or feel like a dweeb for not getting a Saturn. Once I started seeing this in the magazines, I was like so envious. I just wanted, forget about the fighters, forget about the other great games. The fact that I couldn't play this one, that killed it for me. I did, however, kind of like made up for it, even though it's not quite the same game, with Ikaruga that came afterwards. At least that one, I had the chance to experience it myself. This game is killer, man. It's killing me. This is not for the faint of heart. You have someone trolling on shooters and they have this argument about the shooter genre, it didn't last because basically the gameplay was just twitch, and that's it. There was no like strategy to it. You just gotta point them to this game. It'll make their argument so stupid. Oh my god, look at that. I love it. It's almost freaking impossible to move around. Look at that. Now by no means this is a game for me to show off any skills whatsoever, because as you can see, the game is basically pulverizing me. But it is a game that's worth sitting down with, not only getting familiar, but just getting to master every stage, because it's just that good. All that being said, I think I got time for one more. I am crazy hungry right now. I want to get to eat. So before I leave you guys, I'm gonna see what else I can muster here before going. Yes indeed, I have one more here for the shoot 'em up crowd, and this one right here is all Sega, because this franchise right here has been with Sega since the crazy Genesis times, that series being Thunder Force. and this little game by the name of Thunder Force 5. It already has a rockin' soundtrack. It already has me. That's it. I give up. I surrender. I don't need any more convincing, Technosoft. I'm going in. Look at that. Ooh, yeah. Type the window type is, but I'm gonna leave it as is, not mess too much with it. The button set is what I'm concerned about. Okay, shot B and C, and over weapon and ship speed is A and Y. Let's try it out. I don't know if it doesn't work if I don't try it out. ¿Qué pasa, mi pana? Rip Ice, welcome, my friend, welcome. It's sad that you got here almost at the end of the stream, but don't worry, my friend. You can check it out on YouTube as soon as I post it up, because I had some really, really good shooters here. The last one I was playing just right now was Radiant Silvergun, and you know, Rip Ice, how badass that game is. Same thing for you, my friend. I hope you're doing fine. Your family's doing great. You know how it is, buddy. You're always welcome here. So first you get a choice of the order of the stages, how you want to play them. It doesn't matter because the game is going to kick my ass anyways. So yeah, I'm here not to destroy the game. I'm here to surrender to the game, which is completely different. This one, for some reason, now you get to change weapons. Oh my god, you get to change weapons with the shoulder button. I'm already getting destroyed. Oh my god, I'm behind a bush. Can't see anything. Okay, there we go. Die, you bastard! Oh my god! Look at that. 2 minutes flat. Game over. Oh my god. But it's so freaking great. I just want more punishment. That's right. Hell, Rip Ice, if you got to the final boss, even getting to the final boss, you got my respect, bro. You got my freaking respect. One of these days I might try it. I might actually try it. Holy crap. I know what I need. Hold on a second. I don't give a fuck. That's what I was missing in my life. I need freaking music. Yes, one up. I can use one of those. Holy crap, this freaking metal monkey. Metal monkey crab thingy. I don't know what the hell it is, but What killed me? Oh, the little nut things that are growing on top. Holy shit. Wait, wait. Now this is what I'm talking about. I can't. Rip Ice, I don't know how you did it, bro. You, my friend, are something else. Ah, you got the PlayStation version. Okay. Well, right now, I don't know what are the differences between the PlayStation 1 and this one. All I can say is that this shit is hard as fuck. But so, so good. See, when people talk about shooters, you gotta point out these games. These games right here. That's why always my go-to shooters, at least on the console side, on the 16-bit era, it's freaking Gyarus. Gyarus will make you its bitch. That's how it is. Gyarus is freaking amazing. Still love it. 16-bit, I don't care. Oh my god, get away from me. I know it's all patterns and stuff, but whoa. Look at that. And it keeps following me. What the? Oh my god, look at that. No. Can't do it. Can't keep up. I gotta sit down and memorize this freaking game because this game reminds me of R-Type, the original R-Type, when it was played, or when I played it on the TurboGrafx-16 for the very first time. Within 30 minutes, I was saying so many curse words that most of them, I even invented them right on the spot, you know. That's how R-Type, the original one, had me. And this reminds me of the same thing, but in a good way. So let's see before I go, because that one I really sucked at that one. I want to do something else here before actually saying goodbye. How about, let's see if I got something here. Well, I'm going to dedicate this last one to Anthony if it works. Because to be honest, I haven't tested it yet. So if it freaks out, please don't blame me. This one right here, Anthony mentioned it at the beginning. Area 51. So hopefully I'll end it with this one. I know it's not a straight shoot 'em up per se, but it's a damn shooter. You shoot things over and over. So I'm gonna squeeze this one in before I go. Okay, options. Need to have options. Sound options. I don't think there's any music in here. So I can. Oh yes, there is. Let's turn that off. Go real quick. Arcade options. Lives. I'm not too worried about that, or credits, or none of that, because gore on, very important. You always need your gore, so. All right, let's do this. Oh my god, I'm gonna use the D-pad for this. This is gonna be, come on, hurry up! Oh my god, where's the shooting button? Where's the shooting button? I don't have a shooting button. What happened? Oh, there it is. Oh my god, it's the shoulder button. Okay, forget about that. Let's start over. I got the freaking shooting button on the shoulder. as a minimum, be warned that you need either a gun or at the very least a mouse to play this. I am actually playing the worst way possible with the D-pad and a shooting button on the shoulder. If you can believe that crap. But I do this all for friendship. I do it for you guys. Here we go. Oh, sorry, I killed you. My bad. Come on. I hate you, D-pad. I hate you with a passion. Especially the 360 D-pad. Reload, reload, reload. That's exactly right. Oh my god. Again, dudes, I do it for you guys. Get out of the way, woman. No! Get out of the way. Oh my god. You are so gonna be shot. Oh yeah. You drum throwing bastard. Well, if you gave me a machine gun, I think I would have do much better. That's it? Holy crap, that's it. All right. I'm guessing the game had enough of me. Well, that's gonna be it, guys. I'm gonna take this right out of here. Now, before I go, once again, I wanna say, congrats, Anthony, on the second anniversary of the Neo Geo forums over there at Atari Age. Please, guys, if you want to check this out right here, Rip Ice, this is something that's going to interest you a lot. This is a fanzine from the great people from the UK that actually do this. I have a link, and I will have more links on the video description on YouTube, so you can check that out. It's an amazing little fanzine for fans of RPGs in general, and they cover a lot of Nintendo stuff as well as other games, very famous RPGs and games and stuff of that nature. They're really, really cool guys, and they put a lot of love and effort into what they do, so please check it out. And that's going to be all for tonight, guys. Thanks for being here. You guys always rock, and I'll see you guys later. Take care, guys. Bye. Peace.